literally, no one noticed. No one noticed for half a year.
Oh. And the senior prank of my friend's dad's graduating year, they took apart an entire car and
they did go downstairs.
No.
They have a hard time, like,
they can only go
upstairs.
They can go upstairs.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why you see them at the top.
I guess that's why you always see cows in a flat pasture.
Sounds like me in the morning.
Wrong
one to make chocolate.
Who has 7 then? Somebody's got it. There's
a crocodile or gator.
They'll be like flying or something, like mosquitoes.
If they had the size of the brain, the size of a human.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is our honor to gather here tonight in celebration of two beautiful young women. You can hardly tell them apart. They're almost twins.
And so to present those twins, here is Remy and Emma.
Gather around GGB excitedly as she slowly and dramatically gifted us a $5 bill. One of my earliest and one of the best memories.
Yay.
Yay.
Now I can pick up where I left off. As we get closer to the beach, the presence of seagulls grows. The tires of Baba's car softly crunch over the landscaped gravel, soon to be sand particles drifting in the sea breeze. Anyways, okay, I remember. So this next memory is actually more of a short anecdote, if you will. It's about Max. So he was probably two years old, and I tell the story like every year. And we love to feed the seagulls. I think that's something that the Cannon Beach family really prides herself in is we don't waste our food. So we were very generous, actually quite focused. And, you know, I later learned and heard from him why he was so focused, because he'd discovered a way to figure out which seagull bit him. And I think it's best if Max delivers that. So Max, how did you know which seagull bit you?
It had a little bit of red on its beak, but now I know that all seagulls have red on their beak.
Well, like, the entrance was, like,
oh.
And we were both able to fit in at the same time. I don't know how, but no one else knew about it really except for us. So that was one of my favorite memories. Woo!
My third favorite memory is the year that Bapa came up with the Coca-Cola taste test. I somehow placed first, even though I never ever drink Coca-Cola, but somehow I did. So very proud of that.
Okay, so my third is looking for sand dollars, because like this includes crossing the stream even when it's freezing cold and going to the little island and looking for full sand dollars, and like the feeling of finding one is so exciting. And now I can happily say I'll always have a whole sand dollar, because she bought me a sand dollar necklace, but yeah.
And then I think adding on to that excitement, something that we always got so excited about was Uncle Ron. Shout out to you. We are pranks. And we love pranksters. Usually more planning than pranking involved. Some honorable mentions include putting empty balloons under your pillow and putting candy in your ice cream sundae. You didn't know it was there.
All right, to go off of candy, the candy store is my next favorite memory. Stocking up on our favorite candies and walking around town and eating.
Great is just one word, and that word is crepes. That is all.
Yes,
good. My fifth is ice cream and hot tub with Remy. It's a recent tradition, but it's one of the best. There's nothing I'd rather do than stay up till 1 a.m. talking with my best friend about everything that we missed for the past
year.
Nice.
My next memory is, you know, when we were younger, the four of us always just loved to dig the deepest hole we possibly could in the sand and just go at it for hours. You know, it didn't matter, sand in your hair, everything. I was a little less hands-on, if you will, quite literally, meaning that I used a stick most of the time to dig with them, and I didn't really realize that until I looked back on pictures. And one particular year, we were digging the hole, and I was going at it with my stick, and Jake goes, "Oh my god, a crab just pinched me." It was my stick.
In the haystack, I remember working very hard to find sea anemones, only to poke them. Simply for that reason.
Right.
But other than that, I just always love walking with you guys and talking, because there's nothing better than that, doing that with people you love.
That's
so.
Nice.
That's right.
My next memory, so throughout the years, you guys have both seen us and been so supportive and loving to us both. You know, we've really been able to showcase our skills and individual talents, or, you know, in this case, lack thereof, of a more basic human activity. An example of this is, I think, 2010. One year, we managed to lock ourselves in the bathroom of this unit for over an hour and a half.
In the dark.
Yeah, I was scared.
Yeah.
There were sirens, so exciting. My next favorite memory is clam chowder. I don't really know how to describe clam chowder, but it's just really good.
Yes.
So that's that.
My next memory is feeding the birds in the courtyard by Pizza Fed. You know, they're so just cute and little, just adorable little babies, and it was one of my favorite things to do. One of my favorite memories. I fondly look back on it. Up until discovering that pizza crust can clog their arteries and cause death.
Okay, my next memory is the sandcastle contest. One of the most fun activities I have done in Cannon Beach. Building Mollywood and being declared the winners of the Sandcastle Contest is one of the greatest accomplishments I've ever had.
So,
Mollywood, the giant nose.
My next one is a little bit more interactive. I really wanted to, I felt that it was important for me to bring this to part of our memories, because it was something that was so, I think it really was symbolic of marking, you know, our time at Cannon Beach together. One of the first memories I have with Emma, it involves some bubbles. So with the help of Max, if you could just bring up, I really wanted to do a little, you know, to show everyone where we really started. Thank you. Okay, so we just wanted to blow up a little bubbles for you guys, you know. All right, ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
I don't.
What? Is everything okay? What's wrong?
I don't.
Sorry, you guys. You don't want to blow bubbles? Sorry. I'm sorry. Just go with your secrets. Slowly. So my memory 11 is a little not as sentimental, but you know, it's a really good life skill, and actually, you know, shout out to Christina this one. She really helped me. So last year I was just shopping around in one of my favorite stores, Duber's. I'm sure you're all very familiar with it. They have lovely seashells in the back and just beautiful glass everything. Just lovely store. And I was just walking about, minding my business, and a woman stops, and she says to me in the most just little congested little voice, "Can I see you put something in your pocket?" I don't think I had pockets. And so I said, "No, I'm so sorry." And immediately I thought it was hilarious, and I went back and I told Christine about it. And this memory is more about Christine's response, but that was to contextualize it, and she gave me the perfect response for any situation like that I encounter in the future. Just, I'm itchy, and I sure hope this rash isn't contagious.
Okay, the next one is the Hokey Pokey.
Oh,
and
yes,
so,
I can't help it.
Yeah.
Oh, I have to
just,
do this.
Okay. And everyone, please feel free to join in.
Yeah,
please,
absolutely.
Please, okay. And chai tea brought to you by Bill and the other Bill. It is not only delicious, but a very nutritious start to the day. Two or three donuts on the whole really helps.
Yeah.
It's really good.
My next memory is the Cannon Beach culture. And I think that part of that culture that is so pivotal is being able to walk out on the beach any hour of the day and never fail to see some poor, delusional soul out there in 56 degree weather, full on swimsuit.
Okay, my next favorite memory is volleyball and mushball. You know, I just want to say I really appreciate you guys being so patient with me, because I'm really not good at volleyball. Really taught me how, and it's been very nice.
My next memory is watching mushball. From a distance, safe distance.
My next memory is crepes. Not much else to say.
And then adding on to Cannon Beach culture, one year there was a wedding actually going on. They were doing, I think, the wedding photograph. So the wedding party was down there, and I don't know if the girl was really loud. I don't know if I made it up in my head or if I dreamed about it that night, but I swear I heard a voice as I was watching these people on the beach, and I just said, "Sarah, why did you choose this over Maui?" And is it number 7?
The next Transfer memory is pizza feta, the best pizza in the world.
Oh.
And that's all I have to say.
Oh.
Really good pizza.
And then my next memory is crossing the river with Max and Jake, all four of us. It was kind of like our, I would almost call it like a yearly initiation sort of thing, like crossing the river and just going all in, because high tide, low tide, you know, doesn't matter. We're crossing and we're making it across.
Yeah.
I will never forget the feeling of just like the numbing cold and just my absolute resistance to acknowledge that I should be in super cold water, but confident, you know, we're crossing the river.
You
gotta do what you gotta do.
All right, my next favorite one is Mother's Day. The best Mother's Day was when I went to Pizza Feta with Mom and bought her favorite candy, and she started crying.
My next memory is playing music at the bonfires. It's really cool to be able to play, you know, even the same songs and still feel so much love and new love every year. So that's always one of my favorite memories. And then, so for this next memory, so this one is a little bit serious. We want to just ask that everyone please be respectful during this time. It's a memory that we both wanted to include in this assignment. I think that I speak for us both when I say that me and Emma feel like we couldn't fully encapsulate this experience without including this memory. So I'm going to hand it over to Emma now. Thank you so much. She's going to introduce the rest.
Thank you. I want to start this off by just asking everyone to please bow their heads for 5 seconds of solitude.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I just want to start off by saying that this tradition has greatly impacted the history and the culture of Cana Beach. And with that being said, it has been... it has been passed on for many years by word of mouth, and I can say that it will continue to be passed on by word of mouth through many more. Do you need something?
Yeah, we're doing good.
It will continue to be passed on by. Do you have something to say? Do you?
We move on to our next steps in life, and you know, I really don't. I really don't feel like we would. This is the time of our life, you know, and every year we just have the absolute best time, and you know, I
yeah,
really
absolutely.
Think that. We wanted to do a little musical performance for you, so to end it off on a good note. So here we go.
You're the one.
couple of brilliant memories myself about Cannon Beach. One of them is a granddaughter who is as fierce on the volleyball court as her hair is red. Happens to be a granddaughter who sings like a nightingale and possesses the magical transformation powers.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if anybody feels like they'd like to offer some brilliant thing about these girls, or, you know, if you can't think of anything, I get it. But feel free to just raise your hand and go on up and say something about these. Oh, Camille.
My first word is for Remy. And Remy, my two words that I pick for you is you are uniquely artistic. And
yes.
I love you.
Oh.
Thank you.
Oh.
And for Emma, you are stunningly powerful.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. Anyone else? Anyone else has a brilliant memory?
I do.
Oh, okay. Go ahead,
Emma Therese, gifted, talented, dazzling on and off the court. This is just the beginning of brilliant for you. Dazzle on, dear Emma.
Oh,
thank you so much.
Oh,
I love you.
Watch your
head.
Yeah.
Don't let us
joust.
This is a warning. It's a
warning.
All right.
It's a joust.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. Is that it?
For now.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Go ahead.
That's
true.
Well, did I screw up?
No.
No.
Just for Remy, first off, you're so brave and so talented, and it's gotten like better and better and better every year.
Thank you.
With your singing and your presentation and everything you're doing. So with that, you know, I'm just enchanted by where you're going.
Thank
what,
you.
What you're going to do with that.
Thank you.
So good call.
Love
you. Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank you.
And for you?
But you're okay.
Just the brilliant thing I'm thinking of is the last time we raced, I think, I win.
I was in flip-flops. I was in flip-flops.
So I took advantage of the opportunity.
Yes, yes, yes.
Right? And then I blocked you once out there.
Yeah, well, it was even.
But I knew you were something to be had with
yeah.
the memory when I saw you when you were like this big running
yeah.
on the beach once the haystack. But we were behind you walking, and I just sort of was watching you run. Mm-hmm. And I was like, she's got it going on.
There she
yeah.
is.
Dangerous. So first, Emma, well, both of you girls, thank you for all the memories and
yeah.
for making it special here, for all of this was amazing. Emma, I think getting to watch you grow up has been spectacular, and it's not all about volleyball, right? So all the cheer and competition and drive and love that you bring, and when you got to recently spend the night with us down there, it wasn't all about volleyball. It was talking about the future
mm-hmm.
and the accomplishments and the drive. So, well done.
Oh,
proud
yeah.
of
you.
Thank you.
Keep it up. Remy, ever since you were little, you bring a light
yeah.
to everyone. Right? You walk in, you can create. And you're talented, and you're artistic, and you know what you want, and you see the good in everyone, and you're thoughtful and kind and loving and special.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My word for you, Remy, is rare, like a rare gem, stone, pearl. And it's rare, they're hard to find, and there's so much value to it.
Thank you.
and still priceless. You just barely knew me. Emma, your word, I cheated, I looked it up. It's ineffable. I was like, what's your language? It means too great to even be expressed in words. Mm-hmm. And what you've achieved, I mean, there's not many people in the world who could do what you're about to go do. And super proud. It's just too great. So proud of you and just everything that you represent.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
The both of you, so it was just so fun to see you guys carry on tradition. Mm-hmm. And the place when we start out, we're the older ones, and we started out little doing games and coming up with skits, and it's just so fun to see both of you grow up, starting out shy and, or you know, your own little personalities, and now you're like the leaders of our group, and I think you're just like carrying us, you know. It's so fun to see you guys, and the words I thought of were exquisitely beautiful, but it was for both of you because you're just both growing and becoming such beautiful women, and you make our family so proud. So.
Yeah. Right, well.
Thank you.
So far, Tracy and Christine and Bill and Glenn and me and Camille get extra cake.
They said the people that played outside at the soccer game could have it.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay.
We're in.
Anybody else?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Remy Elizabeth. Everybody knows how brilliant diamonds are, and that there's actually a cut of diamond that's called brilliant, and it shows off the stone the very best. Well, about 45 years ago, there was a little girl with red curly hair and a pink tutu who told me that she wanted to be a diamond maker.
That's right.
And when she grew up, she did. She made a brilliant diamond.
Thank you. Oh. Bravo.
Thank you.
Good?
I'm really proud of you for graduating. That is, it's good stuff right there. Also,
first things first.
As far as your guys' performance, I am kind of jealous. You blew my thing out of the water. So, good job to the both of you. Emma, I'm very proud of all you've done. You should be too. Getting through Minogue is hard enough as it is. And especially doing it while fully involved in a sport is something truly phenomenal.
Thank you.
You two are something very phenomenal. You're behind all of our schemes here at Cannon Beach. You were always the woman making it happen in the back. The creative artistic mastermind.
Yes.
Exactly.
Thank
so
you.
Yeah. Please,
thanks,
please continue to do that wherever
you
go in life.
Thank you.
Yeah.
The ability to have joyful optimism and see everything from a bologna sandwich.
That's right.
Yeah. The sunrise with endless joy and optimism. And for Remy, it's looking at the world and seeing chords and
yes.
notes.
Yes.
Her granddaughter Hex.
I thought I was going to be really well organized like these ladies, and I was going to do my homework and I would have something written out, but it didn't work out that way. But I was trying to reflect today on how the journey of these two amazing ladies has shaped Cannon Beach for me and for this family. And one of the things when I was thinking of, someone mentioned fairies and behind the scenes and this magic, and it's not a word, but for me with Remy, I see, especially because when I knew you as a child, you were so very different than you are now. And what your dad said about you bringing light and energy, you bring a joy, like, and you share it. I mean, look what you've got on my daughter's head, and she's worth it. You make people believe that they can do whatever it is that you think they're capable. I am a huge fan of Remy's Instagram page, and you are so creative, and you give people more than the gift of an appearance or a look, because you let them believe they can do it too. And I see you doing that with my kids, with everyone here, and it's just, it's an amazing gift. And I don't know what the word for it is, but thank you for sharing
it
with all of us. I got this. I think I'm all watered out. I never thought you'd be taller than me.
Yeah, it's really weird to walk around town.
It just doesn't feel right. You're so much taller than me. But when I think of every brilliant thing for the way you impact me, it's joy. Mm-hmm. And it's just, you're my sunshine. Mm-hmm. And like Papa said, you can take an ordinary thing and make it seem like something really special. Mac and cheese can be the best thing ever on the right day. And, you know, it's just clean socks for volleyball. Thank goodness they were ready. And it's just, there's a lot of joy in everything. And I just hope that you can carry that forward. You just bring so much joy. So that's my love.
And Remy, I see that joy that I wish I could express. Mm. You are, when I think of you, I think of you at the bonfire, doing your music, making everyone feel good. Mm. And that's such a beautiful talent. Very, very wonderful. And you will carry that always. You make people feel good. And Emma, I'm going to repeat to you what the coach said, that you are so positive. You are a team player. You go way beyond volleyball. You make the whole team what they are. You're a winner.
Oh, I love you.
Oh, no. I'm going to do a little thing for us.
You go.
Okay, we're ready.
You go first.
Remy, one word that reminds me of you is you're artistic.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Bravo.
Emma, you're athletic.
Oh,
yeah. I just wanted to say that you guys are so fierce and powerful, and I'm so excited to see what you guys do over the next couple of years. And just know that all these people in your room have your backs, mm-hmm. serious all the time.
Yeah.
So don't forget it.
Thank you.
I was kind of hoping that I might be able just to kind of slide through this without, you know, not really doing anything, but I feel like I'm cheating myself if I don't do something. So I mean that in a good way, not so I was told that we're supposed to find a word, you know, that describes you guys, or describes a memory. And, I didn't have to look very long. I mean, the word just came to me, and it was charismatic.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
And I looked up the word. This is what it says. It talks about charisma. And it says, I won't be able to read it. a special quality conferring extraordinary powers of leadership and the ability to inspire others, right?
Yeah.
That's what you guys are. And Remy, when you were little, you wouldn't even look at me. You were just that way, and now look at you. It's just this transformation is incredible.
Thank you.
I mean, it's just that yourself looking at it blows my mind. This Emma, we're playing soccer today, and I went to stand in front of her, and my forehead bumped her in the chin.
Oh,
And it was like a realization, oh my goodness, it's little Emma. And so along with that, that voice that she had when she was little, and raspy, you know, those are things I'll never forget. You know, I just want to thank you guys for being who you are, you know, and for sharing yourselves with the rest of us. Because a lot of teens have the ability to shut themselves and separate from their families. And so we're grateful. We're all blessed that you guys do what you do. And I have to just say kudos to Remy as well, because one thing I live for every year is to be able just to, when you come around and just say hi. Hi to me. You just seek me out, and I really appreciate it.
Yeah. I like that.
Christmas. Well, I think we're ready to probably continue on into about midnight or so. We can just go ahead with Max now.
Let's get them all done.
No. I think the girls did great. Would you like to stand out?
Oh, yes.
Watch your head.
Don't hit your head.
Good.
Can you get in that place, honey?
Oh, I'll just go sideways. Oh, okay.
Yeah. And so,
oh my goodness.
Grandma Terry and I would like to present you each with your card. And I guess you did pass, but you still can come and do a little makeup.
Extra credit.
So, Remy. Here's your card and your diploma.
Thank you.
From Cannon Beach Family School.
Oh my goodness.
And here's the purse, and you're going to have to, there are some things in it for you, and you're going to have to wear it the first day of your school.
Makeup. I wouldn't wear anything else.
Picture.
I love it.
Take a picture, send it to us.
Sounds like a deal.
Remy's like, yeah.
No. Okay.
Emma, your card.
Oh, thank you.
And here is your high school diploma. You finally graduated.
Forward looking.
From Cannon Beach, of course.
Cannon Beach Family School.
Nice. And your soccer team is going to think this is really nice when you wear it on the first practice.
Yes.
Soccer practice.
Yeah.
And we get a picture.
And take
we expect a picture on your first
of
day of soccer practice.
Yes.
Yes.
Or volleyball.
Volleyball. Absolutely.
We're very competitive out there. I might as well be.
All right.
Woo!
Woo!
Hey, you guys, back there?
Got some barbecue in Portland style. Why are we barbecuing in the parking lot is what I want to know. Linda, tell us about the weather this week.
It's raining. It's raining now.
Look at this. We got Frankfurters.
Yeah.
We got some corn.
Serious.
Coming off. It's going to be good.
And we got buns. I got to go get them out.